Hey, Chris Menard. In this Excel video, we're going to take a look at removing duplicates using Power Query. I have covered removing duplicates before, and I'll do a quick review. There are chapters or bookmarks down below, so if you don't want to see me do the review stuff and you want to jump just to the Power Query, click on More down below and jump there. But let's go ahead and dive in right now. Oh, feel free to subscribe and ring the bell. Now let's dive in. So I actually already know that I've got two duplicate values, row 8 and 9, or duplicates of rows 2 and 3, just to let you know. Quick review, what you don't want to do is you don't want to select all your data, and on the Home tab, go to Conditional Formatting, Highlight Cells, Rules, Duplicate Values. The reason you don't want to do this, if you notice the city column and the state column, those are duplicates, so that's why everything is already selected. So this is actually incorrect. You can kind of see that row 2, 3, 8, and 9 are duplicates from here, but that's just too much to look at. I would cancel. I would not do what I just did. If you want to use conditional formatting to find duplicate values, you need a primary key field. If you had a list of employees, this would be the employee ID. Employee ID should not be duplicated. Customer number, customer ID, product number, product ID. These are all possible fields. So if I highlight the customer numbers and use the conditional formatting, this will work. There are the customer numbers that are duplicate values, and as you can see, if you look through the rest of the row, that works. Now, if you want to delete them, I'm going to remove the conditional formatting. We don't need it. Let's just clear the rules, the entire sheet. If you wanted to actually remove the duplicates, I could go to the Data tab, Remove Duplicates. You do not want to leave everything selected. You would do Unselect All, and you would key on that unique field, which is Customer Number. So when I'm done here, we should have rows 1 through 7 filled in. When I click OK, 2 duplicate values found and removed, 6 remain. Perfect. Hit OK. That is correct. Nothing wrong with this method, and I use it all the time. I'm going to do an undo, though, and bring those back. The only issue I have with the remove duplicates from the data tab is once it's done it, you would have to run it again next time, and maybe you forget. Maybe this is a shared file. Maybe this file is always being updated. So I'm going to use Power Query to remove the duplicates. This is just another way to remove duplicates. Honestly, I could use advanced filters. I could use a pivot table to do this, but I want to go with Power Query. I'm going to make my data a table first, Control T, click OK. There's my table right there. I did change the style, no big deal. Go to the Data tab, From Table Range. Power Query has loaded, customer number selected. I'm on the Home tab, and we have Reduce Rows under Remove Rows. This is so cool. It says Remove Duplicates. I'm going to click it. It did it. There are my unique ones. Just to prove how cool this is, I'm going to do a Close and Load 2 and Close and Load 2. I'm going to put it in the exact same worksheet I'm in. I would normally put it somewhere else, just to be clear. I'm doing this for training purposes. I'll stick it in cell J1. Click OK. Look at row. What you see over here on the far left has got the duplicates in it. Over here on the right in column J does not. What is cool about this is let's take this 2679. And I'm going to take the one below it, the 2680, and copy and paste. I'm going to leave the 2679 as a duplicate, but let's make this 4001 and just assume that this is me right here. I'll leave the rest of the information the same. So now we've got one more record, but we also have one more duplicate. I'm just going to come over here and click and do a refresh. We should end up with over in J, it should go down to cell J8, and it did, and there I am, but the duplicate did not come in, which was the 26, I can't remember what it was, it doesn't matter, the 2679, yes, did not show up in here. It's only in here once over here. So there is using Power Query to remove duplicates. Hope you enjoyed this video. Feel free to subscribe. My Excel online training class is available. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.